Welcome to my channel. My name is Kika, and today this video is going to be 10 aesthetic photo background ideas for self-portraits, and I'm gonna have some for at home, and also the other half is gonna be for outside. So when we're taking self-portraits or creative photos, I think the first thing is probably the concept or the idea that comes first. But then secondly, a very big question becomes where to take the photo and in what kind of background and environment. When I take photos, if it's inside or outside, I just spend so much time thinking about what would be a good background and what location. So for this video, I just thought I'd make sort of a list of kind of go-tos and backgrounds that I feel work pretty well, and maybe you can get some inspiration and ideas for your own photos. All right, so let's jump right into the video. We're gonna start with ideas that you can do at home. So number one, the most basic and I think everybody will have this, is just a plain wall. But some tips if you take a self-portrait against just a plain wall. First of all, try to look for a wall that has good light, so one that is close to a window. And then secondly, usually if you want a little bit of depth in the photo, it's good idea to step out from the wall a little bit so you're not like completely up against it, unless of course that is the whole point. The second idea is kind of a variation on the plain wall. So it is to make a wallpaper wall, but instead of having to actually wallpaper your whole room, you can just buy gift wrapping paper. And this is super good time of year to do this because it's Christmas season, so there's lots of gift wrap paper in the stores. And then you just basically tape that up on the wall. You can use this kind of washi tape, like this kind of paper tape that won't hurt the wall or won't take the paint away, hopefully. and usually I've found that you need probably 2 to 3 rolls, and then you snap your photo and you can make like really cool, get kind of a retro vibe or more color in your photo this way, like a really cheap way to get a very cool backdrop. And afterwards you can save it and use it for your gifts for Christmas. Ding! The third idea is to use a window. So you can use a window as a backdrop, and especially because usually windows, maybe you have some plants next to them or some fairy lights or curtains. So it's a nice way to kind of bring a story. And also, I don't know, it's something nice, like usually cats sit in windows and look outside. So there's kind of already like a story there unfolding of you kind of seeing the world outside, or kind of a window out to the world. I don't know what I'm blabbering on about, but you know, it's a nice kind of opportunity for some storytelling. Deep stuff here. The fourth idea is to use your floor as a background or as a backdrop. And this obviously will then dictate a little bit the angle of the photo as well. So maybe this doesn't work for all the photos, but if you have a nice floor, it's again like an interesting background to use. And the fifth one is again a version of this. So you can open up books and lay them on the floor, on the ground, and that creates like a really nice texture and background for a photo. All right, moving on to photo location ideas for outside. So when I go and take self-portraits outdoors, I spend so much time just looking for a location. It's a tricky one, but I'm gonna share some of my favorites that usually work, even though, keep in mind, it might take some patience. Just walking around and trying to find a good spot. So the first one is to go to parks and try to find a foresty kind of nature area. That's really my go-to, and especially I live in a city, but kind of pretending to live on the countryside in lots of my photos. So when I lived back in Stockholm, there was this huge park that I would often go to called Djurgården. And here in London, I often go to Hampstead Heath because there's like a huge forest, a lot of meadows. So the next location idea for outside is to go to a beach or anywhere close by the sea or where there's a large body of water. But I think that creates like really nice background for photo ideas, especially if you want a bit of a romantic and kind of nostalgic vibe. There is something about like looking out at sea, you know, it has that kind of very classical vibe to it. And I also personally just really like to be close to any large watery area. There's something very calming and very sort of grounding in that. Okay, the next idea is more for if you live in a city, and this is probably like a huge Instagram cliche, but finding a colorful colorful wall or building. And even though I read some articles saying like, oh, the colorful wall trend on Instagram is dying and I don't think so. It still gives me joy to find a really nice wall with a interesting color or texture. So I definitely think kind of, you know, when you walk around, just make like a little note in your head of kind of colorful walls that you could use as backgrounds. And that leads us to another very much Instagram cliche, doors. And again, London, we really get spoiled here with the doors because there are so, so many nice colorful little doorways that you can use as backdrops. Obviously there's often a lot of people around, so it's a little bit of a hassle to try to kind of nail the photo. But I think all cities, like if you go to the older parts of the cities especially, can have some really, really amazing kind of doorways. And the good thing about that is because you immediately get like a very good framing of the photo, like kind of subframing in the photo. So then when you place yourself in there, you have like a frame within the frame, which is just works really nicely in a photo. And the last idea is to find a street or an alley. And this works so well in photo, like it's a really sort of classical kind of photo framing motif, or what do you call it? Because you have those kind of leading lines and you get that focus. And I don't know, there's just something that it makes it a very strong composition in a photo to use. All right, thank you so much for watching. I hope you got some new ideas for backgrounds for your photos from this video. Let me know in the comments below what kind of backdrops or backgrounds you usually like to shoot. Like, are you more kind of outdoors, nature-y, or more in the city, or prefer to be at home? And if you'd like to see more of my photos, you can come and say hi. I'm over at Kutova Kika on Instagram. Also, just to let you know, I've gotten a lot of requests to do like a Christmas and winter ideas video, and that is definitely coming up. I have a lot of ideas planned, so stay tuned for that. And yeah, thanks for watching. Until next time, bye. A bee in my bonnet, hello. There's a bee in my bonnet, hello, hello. A bee in my bonnet, hello. There's a bee in my bonnet, hello, hello. A bee in my bonnet, hello. There's a bee in my bonnet, hello, hello. A bee in my bonnet, hello.